So I was thinking about this earlier, thinking, well, how do you describe a pull-up? A kipping pull-up is kind of a unique thing. And in terms of the shoulder press and the push press, you could take somebody with no CrossFit experience, give them a barbell and say, I want you to press this over your head. Chances are pretty good at the correct weight that they could press that bar over their head, right? It's just a raw strength element. But the kipping pull-up is a little bit more like a push press. Now I'm using my entire body, I'm timing it, at the last minute, my arms are doing something that maybe they couldn't do without the help of the rest of my body. So that timing piece is highly critical, and that's what you're looking for here. So when I snap from arch to hollow, in the back of my swing, I find this little weightless moment. Only if I come to an aggressive stop. There has to be an end position. So when I'm swinging, I start, I get my shapes, and I'm like, oh, yeah, there's this weird pause where I freeze, and I freeze. I want everybody to try to find that pause first. Go ahead. And I want you to look and see if when you pause, do you see your feet in front of you? Kelvin, that's really nice. Dan, fantastic, yes. Now you're applying the shapes. Through your chest, arch to hollow, Anna, nice job. Great, everybody. So now you're gonna use that same change of shape, and is there a moment where you become weightless? If your rhythm is correct, and if you're tight, there is a moment. So now you're gonna do the same thing, couple of little changes of shape, and can you, oh, hop your hands. Is there just a little light spot? Your hands might not even come off the bar. You might just find a little, oh, light spot right there. Go ahead and see if you can find that. Go ahead, can you find that lightness? Yep, Julian, right. Sorry. Fabulous, Julian, you've got it. Yes, and go, yep, and go, nice, go.